if they're well bred and they've got the right mind. So you saw Jan kind of jump the gun and go fetch these sheep. And you can see if I had a bunch of sheep at home, or Carla had a bunch of sheep at home out in the field and one of them brought to her, she would need a dog that would go gather them and bring them in. So we're going to have AJ take them back out. She's sending her dog Kelp. Kelp is 4 years old. And he's doing a nice job for AJ, coming around on a path of the work called the Outrun. He'll now turn in towards the sheep and take them to AJ. She says, Mom, I just had to go. That lady talks a lot over there. All right, so again, you see a dog that's gathering the sheep to the shepherd. That's the natural inclination of these dogs. So let's send Jan again to this side. Again, that's her Outrun. Going out and around, inspecting the sheep in. Yep, gotta get out of the way. Okay. Now, the sheep kind of get the hang of this little exercise because they know that when they see the dog coming, they should run to the handler. So they're playing an active part in this as well. But even though it's the natural inclination of the border collie to gather and fetch, they also can be taught to drive the sheep away. So let's say we're at home on the farm, the sheep have been in the barn all night long, we want to take them out to their field. So now we've got a couple of white gates down there on the left side of the arena, my left, and we're going to drive the sheep through those two gates, and the gates simulate a gate and a fence line that they may need to take the sheep through. So Carla is communicating to her dog using whistle commands, and this is a nice way to move sheep. She moves them nice and calmly and quietly and right through the panel. Good job, Carla and Dan. She doesn't want to call off. Good girl. There you go. Okay, now, anytime that we're working sheep, it should be done in a nice, calm, quiet manner, if at all possible. The sheep are fresh, they are young, so some of the time when they're moving a little quickly, more quickly than we might like, as being sheep producers, we want them moving at a pace like they are right now. Calm, quiet, steady, not hassle, not stress. So AJ's going to come down and be the next performer. Come on, girl. Stay here in the middle. They're being pretty good, actually, first time away from home. So AJ and her dog, Kelp, are going to demonstrate the basic commands you need to have on your dog to have it be a useful partner at home on the farm. Here's Kelp coming around to fetch them. Get them started. Why aren't you stopping, AJ? Good. Now, AJ is giving verbal commands. And we've got traffic noise over there. We've got me on the PA system. I'm going to try to be quiet when she's giving commands so it's a little easier on Kelp. All right, Kelp is demonstrating one of the most important commands you need to have on your dog, and that's to stop. Can't stop your dog, you can't stop the sheep. And as I said, we don't want these sheep running all around. That's not proper management of livestock to chase it around. So you see the dog stop, the sheep are content to come to a stop. Now if you want the sheep to move, you need to advance the dog towards the sheep. Said walk up. He's advancing towards the sheep. You feel the pressure of the approaching dog and then move away. There you go. Stop it. So the sheep moved off, they should be suspended to a stop. Now that Kelp has stopped, oh, they're going to go exploring. Girls, you can stop. Drift to a stop, girls. They didn't read the playbook this morning. Anyway, let's advance in towards the sheep again, AJ. Right there's good. All right, now you see the sheep did change direction because the dog did. Now stop him again. Let's see if the drifter was stopped by that obstacle. Girls, the drifting to a stop is not working well. Ah, they got it. Okay, now, this is great if the sheep are going the direction you want them to go. But normally they're not. So even if you got a dog to walk up and tell them to go, if they're not going the way you want them to go, you have to have the flanking for directional dogs. to send the dog either clockwise or counterclockwise in relation to the sheep, to be able to then stop the dog and move him in the desired direction. So AJ, how about if you send him up about a quarter of the way, counterclockwise, to move the sheep toward the fence behind you, on that side behind you, right there. Let's bring him up that way. See if you're going past AJ. Walk him up. He says, I like it here, Mom. And again, it's hard to tell here with all these people around. Now how about if you send him clockwise about a quarter of the way around to take the sheep to that fence? I'm going to tell him to come by, staying well off of him until he's in the position. Now if he walks toward him this way, he's going toward that fence. That's pretty good. Now we could stay out here and do this for a while. It would be like a remote control car. We send them there, send them there. But you've got the idea. You've now got a dog that stops when you ask it to, walks toward the sheep, you put pressure on them to have them move nicely. And you can send them clockwise and counterclockwise to be in the position you need them to be. There's one more command you need to have on your dog, and that's a call off. Tell him that and you, and give him a well-deserved break. Good job. Help and agent. Now, we've got something that we started on a few years back. Yeah. And we started doing this because most of the people that were watching the demos, just hang on for a second. Most of the people who are watching the demos think this is just obedience on sheep. The dogs don't know anything, they just take the commands really well. They go where we tell them to be. They don't have to put any brain power into this, they just have to be obedient. Well, that's not the case with a well-bred border collie. This little dog's named Chris. She's a year old, just starting her career as a sheep dog. And she's gonna show basic balance in a border collie. Balance is the dog knowing where to be and where to go to keep the sheep to the shepherd. Now, as I said, it's a natural inclination of the border collie to gather the sheep to the shepherd. So she's doing the basic fundamentals of gathering the sheep. So why don't you go a little closer and send her around. And then Carla is not going to give her a command. She's not going to tell her where to stop, where to go right, where to go left. This little dog is going to do this on her own. Now she already has a nice little outrun on her. Good girl. Watch her bring the sheep. And see, she's checking herself a little bit. And Carla's going to walk over to the other side and not tell this dog where to go. The dog is just, look at this, stop right there to take the sheep to Carla. Carla's going to change direction. The dog, without command, it is stopping where she needs to be. Carla goes that way. The little dog says, oh, I've got to watch these sheep's heads so I know that I'm sending them toward Mom. What a nice little dog. So this is the foundation for a working border collie. Get this balance work down, and the dog is doing all the work. All you're doing is wandering around. This is what I'm talking about. And this is a sweet little dog who's doing a nice job keeping these sheep with Carla. Well done, Carla and Chris. Good job, Chris. She says, is that all I get to do? She's a junior member of our demo team. She's just a year old. Now, you saw the basic commands demonstrated by AJ. So we've got a little something that we do that has no practical application. I warned you before that we were doing that. Anyway, we've got two white cones out there. And if you've been here at demos in the past, you know that we're going to do figure eights around those two white cones. But we're going to make this a challenge. We have two dogs here that are siblings. And there's a bit of sibling rivalry going on. So first we're going to have AJ and Kelp take the sheep in a figure eight pattern using verbal commands. All the dogs are started on verbal commands. And we also add whistle commands as the dog matures in training. We use the whistles because they're more clearly understood by the dog, especially great distances or in a very distracting, noisy location, such as this, the highway over there and me on the PA. So let's see what AJ and Kelp are going to do. Now you're going to have to judge this, so pay attention, because we're going to see which dog does it best. All right, she's going clockwise around the cone on her right. Turn really tight, look at that. Now turn him back to the middle. Nice tight run. Look at this. Man, this is going to be hard to beat. Anyway, through the middle. Now she's got to go to the cone on the left. And a nice turn. The sheep are moving at a great pace, folks. This is the speed that we really should be working sheep. They're not stressed, they're not being hassled. Oh my, another nice tight turn. But she's got to get them back to the middle. Almost. Right there. All right, well done, Kelp and AJ. Good. Let's not spill the grain bucket. All right, if I can find my dog in this mess of dogs here, get over there. No, I'd rather take my own. All right, this is Kelp's sister. Her name's Dan. And I'm going to use just whistles to try to do the same thing, and maybe as well, or maybe even better. And you guys are going to determine which dog does the best job. So I'm going to go off mic so I can whistle to the dog. Okay, folks, I think we got beaten. But let's hear the crowd think. Okay, if you want to vote for Kelp, clap your hands.
Thank you.
Oh, ho, ho. If you think Dan did a better job, clap your hands. Oh, well, Kelp won that one. That'll be next. Dan won the first one, so they're tied. Okay, so you can see that a dog willing to follow a few basic commands can do something as silly as taking sheep in a figure eight pattern around two white cones. And she's got to be in the front row. I told you. And Mike should be in the front row. Stay there, Dan. All right, what's next? Drive this number? Okay, I do need to hook her up. Brian, come here. You have to be back here. I'm sorry. I know you don't want to be in the back row, but you've got to be in the back row. No. Stay there, bud. All right. I need somebody to help me change dogs here. Uh-oh. Brian. Yeah, you. Brian. This is Brian. He's 8 years old. He's been working for most of his life. And he's a really nice dog. I've been successful with him. And what we're going to do, since you've been watching the dogs out here in the center of the arena, we'd like you to see them up close. And also get a good look at the sheep, because they have a beautiful wool on them, and they really are rather lovely creatures. So I'm going to have Rye take these sheep to some numbers around the arena. So since they're there, let's go to number 3. And you folks, when the dog gets his sheep close, take a look at the dog focused. Just like right now, he's listening to me, but his focus is on the sheep. People often ask us, do we use hand signals for the dog? Well, no, I mean, He couldn't see any hand signals because he's not looking at me. He's watching his job receive. So let me get him to take the sheep over to number three. Okay, that's pretty close. Take a look at the focus on the dog. He is in control of these sheep because that's what herding is. It's controlling movement, movement of the livestock. And this dog keeps his mind on his job, all right? How about if we bring him down to number one over here in this corner? Away. Wait.
Here comes the sheep. Here they come.
Well, that's pretty close. It's kind of hard with the pen being where it was. Anyway, you made that happen. Right, lie down. Give Rye a little sanity break here. He's getting a little too into this. And he's not listening really well. So let me give him a little break. Okay, you ready? You're going to listen now? Hope so. All right, we're going to take him over to number four in this corner. Alright, that was a lot better. Now we have one more number, and it's the two over here on this side. Away. Okay, that's pretty close. And again, all I'm telling Rye to do is where to stop, where to advance toward the sheep, where to go clockwise, and where to go counterclockwise. Good boy, Rye. That'll do, buddy. He says, oh boy. He says, I don't know why Mom makes me do that. It's kind of weird. Dogs really like practical jobs, and he doesn't see any sense in taking these sheep with those numbers. Come on, buddy. Anyway. like I say, some of what we're doing has no practical application.